Hello guys, and welcome back to Tracing World Great Western Express. And today we are going to be taking a turn at the freight locomotive. So we've done the two passenger train. I thought we would do a freight locomotive, and today we will be doing a scenario for Chase. I've not really done any of these videos, but we're going to be doing aggregate industries. So we're basically going to take a Baker Poppers at Hayes Tarwick facility there before working over Acton Yard and preparing it for a journey to West Coast. So it takes a bit of driving, a little bit of shunting of things, and should be quite a fun journey. So let's get started. Okay, so we are in
to get these wagons unloaded.
Right, okay. Get wagons unloaded, so slow speed control. Now, okay, what do we need to do here? Select. Right, so, that. Okay, so we need to find that and then select. Right, what else do we need to do? Is it? How do you want me to do this? Ah. What? It's gone. No, it's another. Okay. Okay, there we are. Was a bit hard. Now, turn that on. First reverse. There we are. Three. Slow speed control using F1. Release automatic racer, train going through there. Okay, automatic plate release and throttle to notch one. Now that should hold us at 3.2 miles per hour, hopefully. If that will work correctly. Now this is actually really quite well simulated. I'm glad this is quite a cool thing to put in, I think that's right. I'm not too sure how it works. Anyway, there we are, it's our train. Reverse again. Sidings, I'm just keeping it gliding at this speed. Hoping for the best. Oh, can we go there? Get out of the train. I wouldn't really recommend that, but hey ho. Just thought I'd get out of the train for a minute, just because we can. There we are, back in the train. Let's see what's going on here then. Let's see it all go by. There goes our train, very slowly, but I'm aware we do need to drop off some aggregate into the app. So we need to drop this off. But yeah, anyway, just to let you know, secret, this isn't actually the first time I've done this bit, because I sort of messed up and wrecked this in the thing. I do that again, but yeah, anyway, and also in case you're wondering, you're probably not, but in case you're wondering why I'm doing this scenario instead of service mode, because I did say at one point I was going to do service mode for basically for all the first videos, the first three videos of different trains, and then do scenarios. But I just thought I'd go to scenario for this, because the other ones like HST, the service it operates is what it operates, service mode. You don't need to do anything fancy, you can just drive at A to B. Freight trains, yes, they do drive A to B, but I thought to really get the immersion you need to kind of do one of the scenario at things where basically you've got the freight train like this and you are basically where you've got a freight train and you are dropping off freights, reversing it in and controlling it all. I thought that was the best way to do it and the way that I thought would work best personally. Oh, stopping my speed. No stopping my speed, that's quite clever. It's actually working now. Yeah. There we are, we're coming in eventually now. But yeah, anyway, that's why I did this, because I thought it offers more of a view of what the freight operations of this game are like, because driving A to B, that's no different what you could do in a HST. This is different, because you don't get to lock drop off freight. I thought, I want to see what the freight's like, I just want to have, show you the freight operations, and then, basically, my aim beyond that with this game is to do a service mode scenario for all trains. So, like the, so do one for the Class 166, one for the HST, one for this in the future. And then beyond that, not too sure, really, probably deep with portion. I'll probably then do some more scenarios and things like the Dragline scenario and things like that, and kind of that's one of wanted this, and so I do play with both Dragline scenarios and complete other scenarios, and then just mess around with some writing videos where I just hop around as a passenger. I've got lots of ideas, but time. Now, come on, let's go and get into this sort of area now. They're quite good at the back. That's quite good going at the back. Just seems to be a bit all over the place up here for some reason. I'm not sure why. There we are. I think it's weaker. Look at that. Do the strings move? It's the wheels moving. They sort of sway. It's quite detailed actually for it. It's quite a detailed car. There we are, going in now. Okay, 285 yards, that's how far we are from there. So now that, should start unloading all the aggregate. So it's saying unload aggregate. All 100% at the moment, isn't it? I'm glad to put a foot in. The cooler's easy to go on, so you can use it. Glad I put freight in because it's quite nice to have a variety. Personally, I think they would have been better off doing this instead of CSX heavy haul. I think that would have been better than that first, because while they say yes, it is worthwhile to do it with heavy freight, to be fair, this is relatively heavy freight and requires a bit of simulation. And the whole passenger aspect, we have a further thing. So actually, I think this would be the best one because it has a bit of everything to kick off with. But I can see why they did that. So now, let's hope that all the aggregate loads. It's all low. It's quite cool, that graphic. I quite like this. All quite good detail and things. There we are. Can I have a look around this train while in the food fuse cabinet. Stuff I don't want to fiddle with, probably. So, is all this open? Wow. This train, wow. This train's actually extremely detailed. Pretty much everything's clickable. It's a shame we can't go in the engine room. We can't fly. So much detail. Well, that works as well. Does this work? Not all of it works, but it's quite a bit detailed actually. I'm going to certify this train. They close that door. There we are. Let's have a look outside the train. As drivers do, just let the train climb itself with autopilot. I'm sure that's completely legal. That's a general manoeuvre every train driver does. Yeah. General manoeuvre. Oh, where's the door? Door. Close. Graphics. Okay, it's all loading though. It's doing quite well with the aggregate. It's all getting out of there. The only problem is we are going to hit that. Oh, look at that. HC going through glitching slightly, but HST. Bobby would rather watch in this scenario. What should we have a favourite? It's better maybe, I don't know. Let's load. There we are. Good. 0%. The last one we don't need in it. Taking a bit of time to load all the aggregate, but that's life. It takes time to do all this stuff. Right, there we are. And it is done. Where we are, you see a slow down up in there. Good. Hello. Good. We'll just keep quiet for a bit longer. turn the slow speed control to off, that is fine. Oh, there we are. Down here. Doop.
That was great work. You should get that train over to Acton Yard, where it can be prepared before the return trip to the Mendips.
Okay, right. Should we do that? For the first of all, we've got a completely empty train. That's quite cool. Right, there we are. Yeah, just two. There we are. Release. Good. Stop at Hayes Good Loop. There we are. We can put a bit of power on now, can't we? It doesn't matter if we overload it, there's no passengers to worry about. Okay, and now we can see if this child calls this train is accelerating. There's no load or anything. Should be okay. 15, I think, for the siding, though. Table off the speed limit. Right, there we are. Oh gosh, speeding. There we are, yellow signal ahead, that is fine. Green signals now. Okay, we're meant to stop at that location, that's fine. Are you like going to decouple or something? Not too sure at all. Probably want to stop putting on some brakes in a minute. Look at that. So you think you're doing this guy? Right. Oh, just taking me through. Show me the highlighted carriage thing. That's quite cool. Just looking the highlighted. Oh, actually, probably was doing it for me. Doesn't really matter. Bit out of the carriage loop thing, but does it really matter? Good. Wait for a moment. Moment. Right, I'll wait then. There we are. Good. Okay, so we get to carry on again. There we are. I don't know what our waiting for a moment thing was. What are you to come out with, Lord? I don't know. Get the speed up any minute now, and that train comes out of the siding, it should fully ramp up the speed. So yeah, 25 now. And he was slowing down again. It's always going to be a stop and start at the speed today. But yeah, I'll leave it at 15 for now, then we can get some blasting going on the way to Acton Yard. We do that 5 minute last. Oh, it's a tomorrow's trip. Leave it throttle there, 15 again. The speed slightly, just to give me a bit of probably just over. Not gonna fall off the track or anything. Get high speed in a minute. Oh, yeah. Oh, okay, there we are, come on. Good strong. Good strength. There we are. 85 then. Or is it 80? I'm not sure. 85 is a thing. Line. God, it's the only thing. You've arrived really badly, but lying down. Now, what I won't do is I won't fall out the train now, because there's no chance of getting to get back to the train as well. So I'm not out the train now, so I won't do that. They're all green, but that's a little truck, isn't it? Yeah, but it's about much fun. I think I'm quite good. Road. Not nowhere near my speed limit, though. My speed limit is what? No, sorry, no. Wait, no, what do I mean, nowhere near? It's above it. Anyway. So, we're going to be. We're pretty lucky. I don't know if we'll be able to do the same thing. I think we'll be able to reach our bus today. So, it's going quite quickly along. Along hardly, are we? Different two. I don't like the quite actually easy looking train. They seem safe. Well, big heavy freight train. Get to bucket, it's quite good. 4 miles to go, yeah. Bit of a way. So, oh yeah, this normal, yeah, I basically chose the other one because basically, if I'm going to do a service boat, we're going to be driving from basically Reading to Acton Yard at 75 miles per hour, which I kind of think gets boring after a while. I thought I might be interested to mix it up with some sort of shunting and freight unloading things. I've had a bit of a big drive in the middle. It would be quite a nice, very scenario to do to introduce the synthesis. And then, next video, I will be doing the full road. Because I am aware, I've not actually driven really, I've actually not actually driven the slam at all. I've been doing the slam, that's it. I've gone actually like to the Reading section. So yeah, I'd quite like to do a bit from Reading to Slough as well. So that'll probably be next video in HST where I do a full line version and might stop midway, might go straight through, not too sure. Now that is booked, but that is a 166. Well, that's the movie station, I think, Hanover or something. Oh, it's really quite pretty, it's all quite nice, an old-fashioned. You do get some of those like ones, really old-fashioned. Well, Birmingham Moor Street is one to name an example. That's quite a nice old-fashioned station. I really like that one. There we are, let's run to 75. I don't know when I need to put a brake sort of thing with this train. Maybe slow down to 60 on the top. We're not going back quickly, but at the same time, I don't know how efficient they are. I think they're okay, but I'm not 100% sure. So. Yeah, I'll have to play it by ear a little bit and see what happens. I'm sure we'll get the game of the silence as well. Oh gosh, just feeding it the bell. I never have. other thing that I had. Let's just put on some brakes now. I'll actually put a bit on, just put the pressure in. There we are. It's been really cool though. Quite like it anyway. Oh, that's a tube one. Oh, yeah, red signal. Got the red signal in. Should be okay with stopping there. Some serious brake on, actually, thinking about it. Missed that red signal thing, but we should be okay. It should be tight. I think we'll be fine then. Yeah, I think we're still on the I think we're just about fine. I don't think that'll be a big problem anymore. Yeah, there we are. Okay. Always does that on these class 60s because they have this daft braking system and suddenly literally the second I get the signal it changes. But we stopped, that's what matters, that worked. It's quite detailed to have that. Faster. We did that stopping relatively well. Could have left it any later. Well, that could have ended really badly, but just about managed it. About managed to stop. Good. Right, 0.6 miles, and then we are into active yard reception. Yeah, 30 miles on it. Should be okay. Let's get up to 30 again. Only yellow, so it won't be red just yet. Oh, look, we've got yard trim signal. Yellow, and then license brake. Release them. Got 0.6 miles until the next signal. It's fine. And by then we should have stopped. So that is fine. But we're ready around 50 in a minute. So I'll put some more brake on. Should just bring us down a little tiny bit more to what we need to do. We're going to stop at the location here, I presume. You know what we have to do next. 200 yards. Still quite impressed by how I actually managed to stop the train. That red signal, but could have easily gone horrendously wrong if I hadn't been doing it well. I'm surprised it didn't happen. I'm just going to let it sort of go in, just release it a tiny bit and then just glide in. Siding, so I'm probably just going to stop right now, can't we? There we are. Good. So yeah, we're getting actually here. We're quite close into London, aren't we? We're just outside of Acton Mainline. Objective complete.
You'll need to refuel before the return trip, so detach from the wagons and move the locomotive over to the fuel stand.
Ooh, okay. So, you need to get a couple vehicles. Okay, so climb out of this. This is why I chose this Nordic, and it has little things like this, so you get to save the kind of a track version. I probably should be walking on the track. Anyway, okay. Manual cupping. There we are. That's quite cool. All moving about. That's quite cool to see that. Okay, so we're going for shunt siding. Should be quite a quick journey because we're just on the road now on the train. See how quickly this thing looks anyway. Whoa! It flies up its own side. Power, wow. Not 385 yards, feeling it's hard to cut slow down there. What's that clicking? Oh yeah, is that Axe and Bay line, that station there? That's miles away, yeah. Yeah, so you see, they all look red, but the little yellow two-dot thing, that's a shunt signal showing that we can go through, and the overhead thing says it's cheering and watching. Yeah. What's going on at the... Is this Axe and Bay line over here? Yeah. So we're getting into the London area, the station before Paddington. Good bridge there. Oh, we've stopped. Okay, whatever. I don't know why we stopped. Probably because why I'm incompetent. Whatever. There we are. Bring it down and actually put on some brakes, or else we're going to hit the buffers. It would be a disaster. Oh, we're going to go a bit further forward. We've got no way to control stopping, have we? Good day, actually, fine. Oh! Bottle! Oh, gosh. Ah, I've got to turn off the power. Dear. Hey, just here, hello. Oh, hey, that goes down. Okay. How close were we? Okay. Always good to cut things fine, isn't it? A little bit. Right. Okay. There we are. So where are we going? Backwards. Have we actually got Wimbledon? Are they actually kind of Wimbledon? What if they were? I think they are. So you can reverse it. Because I guess you would need to do a lot of reversing in the Matrix. So maybe that makes sense, but... Could have an option. Maybe it's a bit of a rough exit. Well, you might be. Good. Yellow signal behind me. Well done. Red signal now. Fine. We should go through here nicely. If you're a passenger here, you've got your number front happening with the fate. But you probably wouldn't, you'd probably be waiting for your train if you were in a different region, but that's a thing though. Good. Yard, yeah. Where are we going to go then? In there. How? Right, let me have a look at this. So, where on earth are we? Where are we exactly? There. That's where we need to go. So what, if we're reversing down there, okay, then it's gonna make us go that way. go and release all that weight. Okay, so what's happening? That needs to... Yeah, that needs to go that way, so that'll direct us to there, then that. Yep, that will do that, and then we just need to go back over there. That needs to do that. So that should do that. Good, and that should do that. Good. That should shunt us over there, then we need to stop giving us some brakes. Good, that's that. Oh no, it's gone back. That way, that way, that way. Good. There we are, let's just release the brake pressure. There. Good. There we are, that should get some speed up. Good. That's our train over there. And the brake carriages, we've just decoupled from them. Straight on. If there's up or anything. Good. Put a bit more brake on. There you are. That should be okay. Brake pipe control 4 should be okay. We'll put a bit on. Then we can just release it up to about there. So that obviously 5 is when it's all released. It's all kind of a valve pressure brake release thing. It's all complicated. This is why I told this and I actually get to do things like that. Move a fuel cap. That's cool. Sorry, that's just brilliant. I just like that a lot. Fuel nose nozzle. You see, this is just cool. See, this is what, this is, oh gosh. Over the fuel pump and begin refueling. Oh yeah, you don't have to turn it. You see, this is why I chose this scenario compared to the service mode, because you don't wouldn't get this in service mode, but in this you actually have to refuel the train. That is just brilliant. Good, what's happening now? Place the fuel hose and fuel cap back. Sign of a train, man. Gosh. Yeah. Slightly different layout. That's cool. I actually like how two different cabs have a different layout, and I bet they do in real life. I bet they do in real life. And yeah, see, they are different. It's a different layout. And look, it's a dolphin mainly, but it's kind of a strange shape here on the actual side. Well, I quite like that. Sitting engineer's seat. So where do we need to go? So let's just check everything's up to scratch. That will do that. Okay, that will do that. That will do that. That will do that. Good. That will do that. 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 And that should join us up there. And then we can turn around and go back to there. It's fine. Working this cab. I'll go in the other one then. This one doesn't seem to be liking me. Okay, whatever, let's get on the other side, but Drayman and reverse out. Seems to like that idea. Pretty sensible. You are out of reverse, yes, it's two directions, isn't it? Oh no, wrong way. There we are. There we are. Power to get us going. So yeah, that should, we should all be set up now. So yeah. Then we need to stop there then. Good. There we are, it's our train. Good, reversing backwards. We've nearly finished. We're doing this quite speedily. Meant to be, what, 45 minutes an hour, doing it in 30, well, probably end up doing 40 minutes. It's reasonable. Reasonable. So where are we going? There. And then, okay, so kind of got a wiggle bit, then when it goes past that yellow signal. Let's get a bit more speed. Might go up to 15. Good. Okay, I'm speeding. Good, and then, okay, so then, I'll call them off before, you know, in a minute. But basically, we've got a yellow signal we need to turn around. So, yeah. So after this one, we need to turn around. Where is it? Not further yet. Okay, so we crossed over that one, and it's when we crossed over there. Well, that's 30 signers, basically. Good. Okay, so literally after this junction here is where we turn. So we supply. I'll be now. I'm gone by, that's the train just broken down. What? Okay, so I know what the problem is. I know for some reason the engine was turned off without a button, and now what happens to turn it off? I need to turn the isolation switch off to then press that on, and then just sort out the isolation switch. But unfortunately, for some daft reason, the game doesn't let me press that. Let me do a generator field switch. What a load of good that would do. If I turn that off, that won't help, will it? No. So, generator field can go back on. Just if I don't seem to be clickable. So, the problem is now, unfortunately, basically the scenario was over. I just can't couple up to those vehicles, which is greatly annoying because I won't get my points or anything. But the issue is, that's basically going to have to be the end of the video because I can't get the train to move again because I can't press the isolation switch, which is what the problem is. So, there you are. That's basically it. So, you got the point. All I was going to do is drive up to there, go up to it, go over buffers, connect up. So, literally, you missed nothing. It's just extremely frustrating that it happened about. But anyway, there you are. That's the Class 66 anyway, and it's a really good locomotive to drive. I really enjoy that scenario, and it's just feel like I had loads of variety. But, yeah, anyway, so, Hopefully you enjoyed that. I'll say thank you for watching. Please comment, like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Hopefully next time I'll have a train which I can press the buttons on, which I'm meant to be able to press. So, see you next time. Goodbye.